today we're going to talk about dating tips. I thought that might be interesting. I know a lot of people want to kind of talk about dating itself. And I know that I talk about courtship and that courtship and dating are very, very different. But just for the purposes of this topic, we'll just call it dating, okay? When you actually go out and sit down and eat and all of that kind of stuff. All right. So the first thing you want to know about, hey, Johnny, the first thing you want to know about in dating is to know what you want in a person. And very often in our lives, we're used to, you know, rising to certain challenges, like in our careers and business and school. But then when it comes to relationships, we just don't really know what to do. You know, sometimes a person could be, they could have a PhD and still struggle in this area. I mean, it's just something that is abstract. You know, love can be very abstract, but we still have to, even though it's abstract and even though it's emotional, we still kind of want to take an organized approach to it. And we also want to, as you ladies have already shown, you want to take it seriously because it is important. You spend a good portion of your life with an individual and you want to make sure that is someone that you want to be with. So first is that you don't want to compromise. Just know exactly what it is you want. Now, I know women are known for lists. And I'm list, S-L-I-S-T-S, lists. But I'm not talking about a list like, you know, he's got to be tall, dark, and handsome. He's got to make a certain amount of money. He can't, you know, he's got to pull down the toilet seat and all of that. But you do want to have an idea of what is important. And you're going to have to do work on yourself. We all do, you know, and it's a constant work on ourselves to know what it is that we really want, to know who we are and all of those types of things. And once you know that, it's easier for you not to compromise. Okay. You want to stay hold to those values. The types of things that ought to be on your list is what's your family values? What's your belief system? You know, who are you at the core? Those are some of the things that you want to know about yourself, so you will know what you want in the other person. So this person should complement your life. And the only way you're going to know if they complement your life is if you know you. Okay. And so, you know, very often people get married young, or they could have some age on them, but they still don't really know themselves. And so it's really hard to connect with someone and it really be a good, great fit. And to know that this is someone God sent your way, if you have no idea what your life is, you know, what the essence of you is, and what are you called to do, and what, why are you here, and all of those types of things that we learn about ourselves as we navigate through life. So this person ought to complement you. They will not necessarily be the same as you. Okay. The best relationships is when you compliment. All right. This is why we're so different a lot of times when we connect with people, but the core and the base is the same. What do you need in life? What do you need from this person? And even more importantly, what can you give in this relationship? Know what love is about. Some people get into dating and they have no clue what love is about at all. You know, it's just all about what the person is going to give them and not what they're going to give and all of that. So know the true definition of love. What does it really mean? Get to know what their definition is because you have a certain idea. They may have another totally different idea of what love is. Okay. Love may be sex to them. And I believe I taught this group, if not, it was one of the workshops I did, is that sex is not a relationship. Sex is sex. Sex is not a relationship. Okay. So, but some people think sex is love and sex is relationship and all those things. So get to know what their definition is. Once you know for sure what it is for you, okay, and the true definition, not just some concoction that we find out on the media or from watching television or something. But once you know what the true definition of love is, then you want to compare it to their definition. Okay. That leads us into point two. You want to compare the results. That's what this whole dating thing is about. I know dating has now been reduced to free meal and free sex. That's what it's been reduced to. But if the smart cookie is going to show up on the date, armed and ready to find out information, not like Inspector Gadget, but really just really trying to get to know the person and listen to what they're saying and, you know, enjoy your time there. But you need to come back with some information other than, girl, his eyes were so blue or they were so brown. Beyond that, we got to find out more information. Consider their sexual beliefs. We're going to dig down today when we talk. What are your sexual beliefs? And I think a lot of times women, especially the younger we are, but it can definitely go on to the older, you know, as we go up in age. I know none of y'all are over 21, but the truth is that a lot of us get in trouble because we don't even know what our own sexual beliefs are. Okay. We got to have a good handle on that. What should your beliefs be? Well, you may have a belief, but what should they be? All right. What is their sexual belief? And normally when I do points, I go on and on, you know, a little bit on my talking here. But I mean, this is just down to the brass right here. This is just down to the basics. Will their sexual belief compromise or enhance you? And that's what you need to know. And listen, I think all of us are old enough to understand that if someone is really leaning on us and pressuring us to do something that we are not ready to do, it goes far beyond that. Okay, because, you know, when we taught young girls, oh, if they're teaching you, if they're pushing you to do something you don't want to do, then they're not the right person for you. We need to expand that. We need to say, you know, not only that, when they're pushing you on this, they're going to push you on something else. And they're going to constantly push you to do things you don't want to do. And then eventually you wake up and you don't know who you are. Okay, and it does wear heavy on you, on your emotions and who you become. You know, they can get extremely pushy. And maybe teeter on abusive, okay, or controlling. So you want to really get an idea on this and get it early. Find out early, because it's easier to dodge out early if it's not right than it is to dodge out later on. Don't let anyone take advantage of you. Do you have a tendency to become a victim? And some ladies finally get to this, you know, discovery, men too, that they tend to become victims. You know, they tend to be pushed around or give up on what they see, what's important to them, or not stick to their values or their morals. And you have to figure out why. I don't know anybody enough to notice unless you revealed it to us, whether this is you. But when I was teaching Wise Courtship, I was approached by the Abuse Prevention Association, and they thought this book would be great for that too as well, because it teaches skills that you need to have in order to have successful relationships. And very often people who don't have successful relationships, especially sometimes women, they throw away all of these guardrails, and all of these boundaries are thrown right out of the water, just gotten rid of. And they tend to be victims because they don't stick to whatever their conviction is. And if you are one of those people, you may want to figure it out. Sometimes you have to talk to a pastor or a counselor to figure out, why am I doing this? Because maybe it's going further back. Okay. Maybe it's further back in your childhood, things that happened to you early on, maybe how you feel about yourself, okay, that you are allowing someone to take advantage of you. What can you do to change this pattern of toxicity? And you can change the pattern. It doesn't have to happen over and over again. It can be changed through prayer, through counseling, through friendship with people who are going to be a support system to you. There's so many ways that it can. The reading of the word, all of that, it can be changed. But you have to recognize if you are allowing people to take advantage of you. And you want to find out what are the triggers? Because for some people, it happens very early, very, very early. Okay, and so you want to recognize what that is. Look for love in the right places. Where do great people hang out? Let me tell you this story, guys. I was at this wedding. I can't even remember what wedding it was. I love weddings. I've been to so many weddings. And as a daughter of a pastor, I've been to so many funerals. Okay. But I was at a wedding, and evidently this was somebody that was that I knew well. And we were all very bubbly and happily about it. So I went to the ladies' room, and you know, ladies always talking in the ladies' room, right? And outside of where I was in the stall, the ladies were at the sink talking, and they said, "Oh, what a beautiful wedding. And I wish I could get married to, you know, someone, but you know, there's just, you don't meet great guys at the bar or whatever, you know, I haven't met somebody at the bar, someone with the bar." And when I came out, I said, "Well, you know, if you want a good husband, is that's the least likely place. You may find somebody walking through there or traveling through there, but you got to go where the great people are." So where do great people hang out? And that's what you want to find out. And even some of us who, great women, and we wouldn't go to a bar to try to find a husband. We just, you know, trying to get through life. And yet we still have lost track of this point, is where do great people hang out? All right. That's something you want to think about. Somebody just got a revelation right there. I can feel that, right? I can just feel somebody pull it. I can't wait to hear what you guys say when we stop this. Name places where they don't go. And if they don't go there, don't you go there either. If they don't go there, then you don't go. It's just as simple as that. You know, it's just basic. Some of these things I'm telling you, I know your mother, your father, your grandmother, somebody told you this a long time ago, right? But sometimes when you have a lot of things going on in life, it just get muddy, you know, somewhere along the line. So where do the great people hang out? And if they don't go there, the list of the don't goes, you don't go there either. Understand your feeling and know your worth. Who are you really? I want everybody to kind of, I don't give out homework or anything, but I really do want you guys to kind of meditate on this one, because guess what? We all, as women especially, have to visit this over and over and over again. Even when you get married, even after you have children, all you got to go back to this. Who are you really? What do you care about? What value do you bring? You got to always come back to that one, because, you know, even if you had a successful marriage and now you're a widow, or even if you had, you know, you were a single woman, you had children, or you were a career woman, went to school and you haven't gotten married yet. We tend to get flooded with so much stuff, and we tend to be so relational, taking care of mom and our friends and hanging with our girlfriends and taking on everybody's problems, that we forget who we are really. What do we care about, and what value do we bring? Okay, so you want to understand your feelings and know your worth. Believe what they tell you. Maya Angelou said, if someone shows you who they are, believe them the first time. If they show you who they are, believe them. Okay, if they're arguing and fussing and fighting and stuff, believe it. Okay, all right. There are some exceptions. If you've read the Wise Courtship book, I've given you some examples that, you know, someone can tell you one thing and you say, okay, and then you see them do something, you're like, But then after research, you really get the answer. So if you come into a room and they're in there yelling and throwing things, you're like, But if after research, and I use that term kind of loosely, you know, but after some, you know, understanding, you find out that their mother just passed. Well, that kind of explains that behavior. But when you're going to a restaurant and they're really snotty to the waiter, and then, you know, they kind of get hot easy and all of those types of things. I mean, you have to believe what you are seeing and you are experiencing. Okay. Don't make excuses for this. And we sometimes as Christians we are notorious for this. Okay. Oh, well, you know, and listen, it's okay to call a spade, okay? You're not sending anybody to hell. We're not sending anybody to hell. We just recognize it, that this person right now is not ready at this moment to be attached to you, okay? You can pray for them at a distance. Lead them at the altar, okay? And you go ahead on with your life. Are you listening to what they are saying to you? What they are saying to other people? Are you listening? What is coming out of their mouth? Okay. It's so important. beware of technology. And this one's a little bit longer, this presentation. It's a little bit longer, but bear with me because there's a lot in this. Don't let social media rule. I like this picture because I have gone out with my husband and seen people at the table like this. This is before the pandemic. Okay. We'll see people at the table just kind of like looking just like this, looking at their phones. Okay. But I've given you my thoughts on online dating. I won't go into it as much. You can, some of you who were watching this at another time, you can look at a lot of things that I've written or other videos I've done, or after this is over, you can ask me as well. But just be careful of online dating. Just do your due diligence, because what happens is that sometimes when you have things easily, readily at your fingertips, we rely on the technology to do the work that we should have been doing ourselves. Okay. And so you lose some things in the process. Okay. Let me give you an example. When you buy a cake at a store, it is not like mama's cake or grandmama's cake. And so there are some things lost in the process. And actually, that cake is probably going to be a whole lot better, even though it's from the store, than maybe online dating. Okay. You make some mistakes in that, or you lose some of the flavor in that. There are some repercussions. So I can go into that further. I won't go into that now unless you have a question about that. All right. And so we're about to, at the end of the presentation, but utilize the three-step system when you are dating. This three-step system is right there in the book, Wise Courtship, the book that I was talking to you about. You can get a copy right at wisecourtship.com. Now, anybody who's been part of this group, no, I don't put a whole advertisements at the end of my thing, but we are talking about dating tips, and I'd be a fool not to tell you, okay, to get it. And that was the only courtship book on the market for years. It got picked up by the WorldCat system. And so now there's a couple other books trickling out about courtship. So make sure you get a copy and learn them three steps. I'm telling you, they're practical. This is no theory book. Okay. Even though my degrees are all like in psychology and business, and I'm, you know, y'all know I'm a professor and all that stuff, but this is no theory. This is practical stuff, things that you can use. So you want to get a copy and you want to keep it with you. Hey, thanks a lot for watching my video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'm going to try to upload videos as much as possible. So make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. Take care.
Are you subscribed to the Wise Courtship philosophy? Then you need to get your Wise Courtship gear at the Wise Courtship store. Go to bit.ly/Wise Courtship Store. All the letters are lowercase. They make amazing gifts from children, adults, men and women, jewelry, hats, cell phone cases, t-shirts, and more. Represent Wise Courtship by going to bit.ly/Wise Courtship Store.